Is there a Windows 11 installation media download? Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. You know, for the better part of two decades, I have been strongly suggesting that whenever you get a new computer, you get the installation media for the operating system that came pre-installed. Sometimes that happens, but it's becoming less and less common. Manufacturers are saving money by not throwing more physical stuff into the box. Physical stuff that honestly a lot of people weren't using anyway. It's only the people that ran into problems, that desperately wanted that installation media and of course didn't have it. However, things have changed. A lot of things have changed. And one of the neat things about those changes is that yes, you can download Windows 11 installation media. Let me show you how. So if we take a look at the address bar here, what I'm pasting in is my own shortcut, go.askleo.com/win11download. If the destination ever changes, this link will continue to work. But basically, it's taking us to Microsoft.com's Windows 11 download page. Exactly what we're looking for. Now, there are, of course, three separate kinds of downloads, which is what makes it a little bit confusing depending on what it is you're wanting to do. The first one, the Windows 11 Installation Assistant, is focused on upgrades. So this is the place you might come to if you've got a Windows 10 machine and you're wanting to upgrade it to Windows 11. This will download the tool that actually checks for compatibility, and if that works, then you're fine. It'll proceed to install, download and install Windows 11. What's more interesting, at least to me, for existing Windows 11 users, are the Create Windows 11 Installation Media. If we download that and run it, that will run what's called the Windows Media Creation Tool. It's checking a few things, but what's important about this tool is that it will now create for you installation media directly on the media of your choice. That means that if you have a USB stick that you want to be the bootable installation media, this tool will create it. If you're creating a DVD with Windows 11 installation media, this is the tool that will do it. You'll notice that it's asking use the recommended options for this PC. Basically, it can use your current PC and kind of make some choices in advance. If the installation media you're about to create is specifically for this PC for using it later, absolutely, leave that checked. Otherwise, uncheck it. The download will be a little bit bigger because it'll include some options for PCs that don't look like your current one, but that will allow you to still create installation media. I'm going to leave it checked and click on next. Now, as I said, you've got a choice here. You can use either a USB flash drive or you can have it write to an ISO file. Now, in this case, it's saying writing to an ISO file because this machine has no DVD burner. You would then take that ISO file to another machine that does have a DVD burner and burn it to the DVD, and all would be well. I'm not going to go further with this because basically this is probably the most common approach to generating the installation media you need. I don't need it right now. I don't want to take those next steps. If I cancel this, there's a third option. And that is simply to download the Windows 11 disk image directly. In the previous step, we created an ISO, or we were able to create an ISO only because we didn't have a DVD writer. This basically gives you what most people are looking for. Even though they might be better served with the media creation tool, most people are saying, just give me the ISO. Well, here it is. Windows 11 multi-edition ISO for 64-bit machines. That's often all you want. That is an easy one. It will download the ISO to your machine, and then you can do with it what you will. This is what I use when I'm spinning up another virtual machine. I basically have the virtual machine boot from this ISO and then install Windows. Now, there are, of course, a couple of caveats with this. One, Windows 11 is big. It's a big operating system. You'll notice that CDs are not one of the options, right? 640 megabytes doesn't capture it anymore. You do need a DVD, and in fact, buried in some of the instructions here are what to do if your DVD isn't big enough. Sometimes 4.7 gigabytes might not be big enough. There are workarounds, but that is one of the things. Your USB needs to be, I think, something like 64 or 128 gigabytes in size, so that'll be fine no matter what. But note that that's a big download. If your internet connection is slow, it's going to take some time. If your internet connection is metered, that's going to eat up a lot of data. So be aware about what you're going to do when you download your Windows 11 in whatever form you download it. The other, and I call this caveat OEM in the companion article, that is simply this. What we've downloaded using this page and these tools are the generic Windows 11 Retail Edition. There are no customizations for specific OEMs beyond what's available in Windows Update. What that means, though, is that, one, if you've got a machine from a manufacturer that you're aware of, like, say, a Dell or Compaq or others, then you might want to go to those sites first and see if they offer their download image that might include additional tools and drivers specific to those machines. On the other hand, if that's not available or that's not something you want to do, then after installing this retail generic version of Windows 11, you may still want to go to their support sites and see if they offer downloads of drivers and applications and more that, again, are specific to their hardware. Most of the time, you can live without those, but often having those drivers in particular, and sometimes the support and diagnostic software, will make some things easier in terms of enabling more functionality in the hardware that you have, or allowing you to do a closer diagnostic of the machine in conjunction with the manufacturer's support offerings. But that's it. As you can see, you've got several options to download Windows 11. This is how you do it, but now you know you can. For updates and comments and links related to this topic and more, visit askleo.com/172361. I'm Leo Notenboom, and this is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.